Hi everyone, I'm Ken from Crypto Trading KS. Let's run the numbers. Bitcoin currently 63073, down 0.38%. Ethereum 4598, down 0.49%. My goal is to assist you to be more of a financial blessing to yourself and those you love, and also gain real wealth in the process. I've hidden knowledge gems throughout this video. Unless you watch to the end, you'll miss them. See how many you can find. Rule 774, master yourself to master the market. Self-mastery becomes much easier when you understand and know that you are worthy and unique. You deserve kindness, love, meaning, and every success in life. Every success in life comes down to things like inner and outer peace, fulfillment and meaning, empathy and love, health, purpose and fearlessness, as well as money and security. Every human being lives by unseen rules. These are subconscious rules that impact our behavior. Our actions always align to our subconscious rules, our hidden rules. For example, many people look at wealth, look at money as something to be avoided subconsciously. If you ask them consciously, they would say, absolutely, I want as much money as I can get. I want to be safe. I want to be secure. I want to look after people around me. That is quite common. But sometimes there are subconscious rules that get in the road of making money. And of course, this also applies to components of real wealth. When we talk about inner and outer peace, fulfillment and meaning, those things, sometimes people think that they do not deserve that. Or if they have inner and outer peace, somehow they're being weak. It's not the case. You need to be really strong to have inner and outer peace. Literally, the only way you can ever change your life is by changing the hidden rules that you live by. And this is not easy because you must bring the subconscious into consciousness. Many Western people will know 1 Timothy 6:10, for the love of money is a root of all kinds of evil. And basically that's been summarized through the years. Money is evil. Unfortunately, money is not evil. What gets missed here is not that money is the root of all evil. Money is just a neutral energy. It depends on the focus of the person that has the money. A good person with money will do more good. A bad person with money will do more bad. It's what I call the scalpel principle, the knife principle. The knife in the hands of a surgeon will heal. It's the same scalpel, the same knife. That same knife in the hands of a criminal could kill. One of my favorite movies when I was growing up was Star Wars. I watched the original like 11 times in the cinema, often by myself because my mum and dad would just drop me off and say, not again, Ken. But what I saw in Star Wars was the classic fight between good and evil. It just somehow resonated with me. If we think back to Anakin Skywalker, who became Darth Vader, of course this is a film, but it says an important story. Anakin was consumed by hatred, by negativity, and he became Darth Vader. And if we look at Yoda, Yoda pursued an excellence course in all things about the creation of life and the harmony of the universe. Darth Vader was simply out to destroy the universe and bend it to his will and everybody inside it. That's why we can talk about excellence as being either positive or negative, life-affirming or life-destroying. Positive or negative excellence starts with thoughts and ends with actions. Now let's consider it another way. Let's take it out of science fiction. Say, for example, that the two richest people on planet Earth were Darth Vader and Yoda. What would they do with their money? Would it be the same thing or would it be different things? Please let me know in the comments section. I'd be really interested in your thoughts. I'd like to reach out and say thank you to Mr. Fantastic. What a great nick. It's just a fantastic nickname. Mr. Fantastic said, I feel like I'm a solid zone 3 now. That's all about probabilistic fearlessness. Now I've been working on zone 4. That's the meaning zone. Been more in the present moment with my family and friends, and my relationships have gotten better. I used to be way in my own head and not present. What a difference. Can't thank you enough, Ken. It's a great honor, Mr. Fantastic. Well done, my friend. Beautiful. Mr. Fantastic was talking about chaos zone analysis, the four stages that all investors and traders progress through to become consistently profitable and attain real wealth. All investors become traders anytime they buy or sell. That's an important understanding. Zone 1, the panic zone. Zone 2, the blame zone. Zone 3, all about probabilistic fearlessness, knowledge and forgiveness. Accountability and learning is the patience and rule zone. With gratitude and worthiness, people enter the meaning zone, zone 4. People can literally enter zone 4 at any stage, but it takes zone 1, 2, and 3 to get to zone 3. Zones 1 and 2 suffer the light switch effect. Basically, people are all in or all out. They want, and that's really fair when you're just beginning, 100% certainty to be 100% correct 100% of the time and have zero loss, only wanting positive awareness of things and absolutely no uncertainty. They want a time, the exact top, the exact bottom, and they want to know it to the date. And they don't want any negative moves because that means that the positive move is over. Zone 3 is very different to Zones 1 and Zone 2. This is all about probabilistic fearlessness, having a strategy, an upside strategy and a downside strategy. Negative percentages are just buying opportunities, and we can scale in and out of any particular thing. It's all about patience, rules, discipline, and negative awareness of what is happening in the world is absolutely fine. And most importantly, Zone 3 and Zone 4 people are really good losers. They just look at loss as the tuition fee of the markets, and they're quite happy to pay it because the next time they'll lose less and less and less until they start being profitable. Literally, there's so many rules that we need to unwire subconsciously to become profitable consistently. That is exactly why I spend so much time up the front of every episode to help you to see how to get into Zone 3 and Zone 4 if you're in Zone 1 and Zone 2. And it's really all about emotional intelligence, overcoming and being very much superior to normal intelligence, IQ. EQ outweighs IQ in financial markets. Turning to the chaos model, which is a crypto technical trading model based on institutional price psychology, I just wanted to talk a little bit about where I see this all playing out in terms of the bear market. I do anticipate that we will go through the same kind of cycles that we've seen. I'm assuming a worst case scenario of an 85% drawdown from the top of the bull market. If we're getting that, that means if the projection comes to fruition of 486,000 on the 25th of May 2022, and that of course is an approximation, but I think it's a reasonable one, we would be looking at a low of around 72,900. If it gets to Plan B's 288,000, the low with an 85% loss in value will be around 43,320. There's a lot of people that say they expect 100,000 to be the top. I do not believe this will be the case. We have, inside the crypto space, mathematically protected all-time highs. The mathematical protection basically means when price trades over the previous all-time high, it doesn't come back and trade below it. We've seen this time and time again from cycle to cycle. If the price reaches $100,000 and gets an 85% loss, the price will go to $15,000. The previous high was around $20,000. This is what I call a violation. Even if it goes to 131,107 and decreases 85%, it will still violate the approximate $20,000 from the previous 2016 halving cycle peak. If we just say that it manages to get 1% above the previous peak, that would make the basic top 132,418 at the absolute minimum. If it gets 10% above the previous 20,000, it will be 144,217. There's a lot of things that we have to watch for. Of course, we could get black swans at any time, these lightning bolts. If we do, price would be expected to recover anyway. We've had so many black swans throughout the whole process. It doesn't make much of a difference to Bitcoin and crypto. That's why I have this white line in here, 132,418. This is what I call the absolute minimum high. Anything below that will break the previous all-time highs mathematically protected line. I don't believe that's going to happen. The probabilities do not favor that. Unless, of course, there's a black swan event. If that happens, okay, it happens. But it will normalize out. We had a black swan event here on the 12th of March 2020 with the US liquidity crisis and COVID. You can see how fast the repair was there. It just shot up. We just have to be aware of these particular mathematical properties of Bitcoin. Not a lot of people are discussing the mathematically protected all-time high. A lot of people also say that the halving cycle is just not relevant. I would like to give you a bit of a different view on that. This is miner revenue. This is in a linear scale. It doesn't look like it's really following price action at all. But what happens when we do a log scale? We can see miner revenue is following the trajectory of Bitcoin, and it will continue to do so. It is just baked into the mathematics that is Bitcoin. When we look at Bitcoin net unrealized profit or loss, NUPL, we can see that we're just in the belief stage at the moment. We're not into the euphoria stage. When we get to the euphoria stage, we need to get out. When we see the capitulation stage, this is this red line, that's when we want to get in. We basically sell blue, buy red. We can see we're nowhere near either at the moment. When hype and mania are present in a market, especially Bitcoin, the number of new addresses will spike up as more and more people get involved. We can see we're very low on the new address count at the moment. What does this mean? It means we have space to go. This party is not over. It's really just getting started. I put a poll up. When do you think Bitcoin will peak? November to December this year? About 29%, January to March next year, 42%, March to May, 30%. People are feeling that it's going to be the first quarter of next year. Wherever it is, we'll be tracking it, and there are many signs that I'm looking for. I'm not particularly wedded to any position as far as Bitcoin goes. The price action will display the reality to all of us. And when it does, I'll be there to let you know what's happening. I also did a poll on Twitter. When do you think Bitcoin will peak? November to December, around 33%. January to February, 32%. March to May, 35%. As far as on-chain data, we can also look at the total transfer volume to exchanges. We can see that's really, really low. Past peaks, it was getting choppy and getting high like this. We're seeing very low transfer volumes. It doesn't indicate any kind or any sort of near-term top. Going back to the 2016 bull run, it's really important to understand that there can be very large gains, but also 20, 30, 40%, and eventually 50% drawdowns in price. These are very scary to go through. Just have your strategy in play. And it's always good to think with the eyes and mind of an investor. When you think about Bitcoin, Fidelity Investments put this out, this analysis, which is the stock to flow model. They're anticipating Bitcoin $1 million per Bitcoin in 2026 and $10 million per Bitcoin in 2030 plus. These kind of figures may seem a little bit outrageous, but just remember where Bitcoin started. It was virtually worthless and came up to what it is right now. And it's doing that for very, very specific reasons. Bitcoin has a fixed supply of 21 million Bitcoin. It is not fiat. It is decentralized, outside central government control. It can bank the unbanked. And the most important thing to understand, it's the foundation of the next evolution in the internet of money. It's all about the alts building out on the Bitcoin cryptographic ecosystem. It's a global medium of exchange. It actually bypasses currencies. It's a global store of value, facilitating low-cost global transactions. It's an apex exponential asset class. It's pretty neat. Turning to Bitcoin's technical analysis, we can see Bitcoin currently trading at 62,759. It had a little bit of a sell-off, but it found support and it's trending up. It's actually over this once resistance line and it's being supported by this upward resistance line. Upward support line. It does have resistance above at around the 63,511 mark. And that's probably why we saw a bit of a sell-off just recently. It's just trying to get above there. There's an epic battle going on between the shorts and the longs at the moment. We can see in the green line, a lot of longs came back into the market when we got over this resistance and turned it to support. Now what is happening? The shorts are starting to come back into the market. They're trying to cool off these longs. Longs and shorts exist in a symbiotic relationship with one another. When things get too hot, the shorts come in and cool off the longs. When things get too cold, the longs come in and warm up the shorts. It's just the nature of the market. We, of course, have issues, and financial markets always have issues. We still have the Evergrande situation. The tapering issue is on the table. November 16, the Bitcoin Taproot upgrade. We're looking at November 20, the rehabilitation of around $9 billion of Bitcoin. Janet Yellen's unrealized capital gains tax, the debt ceiling, December the 3rd, the Ripple case, crypto lawsuits. If you look around, there's no shortage of negative news, but there's also positive news in the market. What we do is that we trade the chart that you view. Just trade this. Trading the current chart is called probabilistic fearlessness. We just go on the basis of probability. It's going up. It was a little bit weak there, absolutely, but it's still going up. The probability, we go with that probability. The key is don't panic. Don't get into the light switch effect. We have a lot of storm clouds on the horizon. Make no doubt about it. That's correct. But things take a lot of time to play out in financial markets. Being aware of the risks is really important. And that's all about Zone 3 and Zone 4 behavior. But the key is have an upside and a downside risk strategy in play. If, for example, Bitcoin or your beloved cryptos go up, exponentially up, how are you going to deal with that? If they melt down, how will you deal with that? It's just about deciding in advance. I always draw attention to this. Make in advance probabilistic choices. It's a fantastic way to go. Just say, if it goes up, I know what I'm doing. If it goes sideways, I know what I'm doing. If it goes down, I know what I'm doing. And make up your mind and just stick with your plan. That will help you sleep really well at night. All the markets are interconnected and interrelated. A big mistake a lot of people make is that they think the crypto market is immune to market movements outside, say the stock market and bond market. That's just simply not the case. If we look at the volatility index, the VIX, the fear gauge of the market, stock market, we can see the fear is just falling down. Now, what does that mean? Price is rallying. Look at this rally up. what is the stock market doing about Evergrande and tapering? It's just saying, I don't care, I'm partying. And it is partying hard. What about the DXY, the US dollar currency index? It's on its way up. Bitcoin is just consolidating at the moment. What a big move up Bitcoin has had. This is just a consolidation pattern and we're getting a breakout. What about bond prices? They're still under resistance and they're resuming down. Bond yields are above support and resuming up. What's happened to gold? Poor old gold, it's going down again. Gold just can't make up its mind what it's doing. In the last episode, I mentioned that I thought that based on probabilities that the oil price would start to go down. It has indeed done that. And these prices are always moving in a wave. It will go down and up and down and up. That's just the natural pass of the market. Now we have a really good appreciation of what we're looking at. The S&P 500, the proxy for stocks, is up 35% over the past year. Gold, we see it going down, down 8%. And Bitcoin is up 346% for the year. Looking at Ethereum's technical action, ETH is currently trading at 55.58. We can see that the price is obeying this particular support line quite well. We're getting up over this once resistance to support another level of support to all-time highs. It's looking pretty good, but as always, have your side covered, upside and downside. If it goes up, what will you do? If it goes down, what will you do? These are the really important things to cover off. We just trade the chart that we view. Rule 185, radar opportunities. Looking through the top eight, we can see Bitcoin is finding support, just coming back to test that support and resuming off. We can see Ethereum breaking out to new all-time highs. Binance coin following Ethereum, or is it Binance? Ethereum following Binance. Ooh, that it could be interesting. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Cardano, ADA, starting to get up there. Go ADA. It's about time. XRP starting to rock and roll, as is Solana. Doge still remaining a little bit suppressed here, but close to support. And we can see DOT is doing rather nicely. On November the 4th, the crowd loan start, and November the 11th, parachain auctions begin. So it's not surprising that DOT is doing okay. Rule 444, ignore tips, advice, and marketing. And of course, always do your own research. If you find something that looks good, please research into it. I always suggest when you look through opportunities to identify no more than three. Otherwise, you'll become overwhelmed with choices and you'll spread your money very thin. It's better to concentrate it. Let's have a look at Algo. Algo is being supported quite nicely in price. It's going through a cradle. This is looking good. We can see SHIB has dropped about 20% today, and we were saying be mentally prepared for 30, 40% plus drops. They're quite probable. That's just the nature of crypto, especially with this kind of price action. Luna is slowly making its way up, doing quite nicely. Let me know in the comments what you think the top three would be and why. That's always a really good thing to discuss with other community members. Nobody is right or wrong. It's just your opinion, and it comes down to why you're doing it. Are you investing? Are you trading? There's so many different things you can be doing. Uni is getting above this once resistance, turning it to support. We can see AVAX starting to rock and roll. Chainlink starting to get up there to gather momentum, as well as Litecoin and Bitcoin Cash, but they're really lagging, especially Bitcoin Cash. Having a quick look at the next eight, we can see Stellar is getting above this once resistance, turning it to support. Matic is looking very nice. It has some good positive momentum. Cosmos, Atom, is coming back and seeking to get above this support line that turned to resistance is trying to get back and turn it to support. We can see Filecoin starting to turn around. These turnarounds can be slow, but when they get going, they can be quite explosive, as we've seen many times. ICP is seeking to gain momentum. Axie Infinity is looking very strong here. We've got upward support through here. It's looking quite nice. FTT is coming back to a level of resistance. Tron is making its way up slowly. Turning to the community favorites, Veracity is on its way back up. Icon coming back to retest this support. Holo Hot is hot now. The party is in full swing. Cody making its way up slowly. Multivac, we're seeing some weakness developing here. Chili's, we can see Chili's selling down and coming back to support. It's quite common that these cryptos do this. Loopring has been on an absolute tear. The party police have been called in. They're trying to cool that party down a little bit and not having much success. CRV coming back to secondary support. These are Metaverse projects traded on Binance. We can see Mana Decentraland just consolidating. It's done incredibly well and held the price very nicely. Axie Infinity on its way back up, as we discussed a little earlier. Engine Coin looking very nice, a lot of support through here. SLP is a counterpart to Axie Infinity. That's why we look at these two together. We can see SLP has been under pressure for quite a long time. Sand is doing incredibly well. YGG, Yield Guild Games, wow, that's a tongue twister, is on its way back up. Alice is finding a level of support, and Ghost is above support and looking quite strong. I'd like to thank all the very kind and generous community members that have reached out and bought me a coffee on buymeacoffee.com/cryptotradingks. I'd like to thank Linda for her very nice comment, as well as Princey. Thank you so much, Princey. Many of these comments are private comments. Of course I read them, but I never show something that is private in public. Cedric, thanks so much, Cedric. And Eleanor, thank you. Francois, thanks so much, my friend. And Jimmy, thank you for your comment too. Much appreciated. It was just a private comment. As promised yesterday, I put out the new coffee club video. I just do this as my way of saying thank you for your generosity. If you're a coffee club member, you just go to the post tab and click on it. And then you will see there are actually 4 coffee club videos. One goes through rule 305, assessing volume integrity, rule 402, rule 420, which was the latest one that I've just put out, and rule 18. I hope these help. It's just my way of saying thank you so much for your generosity. I'd like to also thank the many community members who've reached out and expressed interest in the Crypto Trading KS Masterclass. The Masterclass goes into a much deeper dive into the trend and the timing and introduces the trigger process, what and where to buy and how to sell. It's going to be very interesting for people. If you would like to lock in your very substantial Masterclass discount, please email me at ken@kenstanfield.com. Stanfield has 2 D's in it. I'd just like to let you know that if you've sent an email to me, your discount is locked in. I'm slowly making my way through the many, many emails. If I'm delayed in responding, don't worry. Your discount is locked in. The financial markets can be very frustrating, and it's easy to get angry sometimes. I found that replacing anger with gratitude and appreciation is a very fast way to get into real wealth. When things don't go your way, if you look at it from a positive learning focus, That allows you to apply gratitude and appreciation to whatever angered you or disappointed you. I always share this quote, "You are worthy and unique. You deserve kindness, love, meaning, and every success in life." And that is because this helps to rewire the mind towards worthiness and success. I hope you found the content useful. Please consider sharing and liking this video if you think it will help others. Thank you very much to our moderators for keeping our community safe from scammers. If you're new to the channel, of course, a big welcome, and please let me know if you have any questions. If you would like daily updates on price movements in the crypto market, please subscribe to YouTube. I've left helpful links in the description of this video. Please remember, crypto is volatile. Always prepare yourself for the best and worst case scenarios. Reality will likely be between them. Stay safe out there. Take care, and see you next time. Bye for now.